What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 17 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest IX. We are at the top of the Tower of Trades, where we'll be finding Abbot Jack. Let's go in through this door, and there he is. Let's talk to him. This does not look good at all. Bunch of dark energy. And look what it has done to Abbot Jack. He's now a hideous monster. Greed and power will consume us all. And now, look at you. And it's boss time, the Master of Nuon. Alright. Let's get down to business. Let me try out my crackle spell here. Try Beazle Freeze as well. Perler Blade, and I doubt Pressure Core is going to do anything, so I'll just use Mercurial Thrust. Not quite sure how much HP this guy has. That Beazle Freeze did nothing. Oh yeah, this guy can also attack twice per turn, and ouch! Well, Crackle did okay damage. Maybe we should just get back to egging on our attackers here. Blue's gonna need to really do some healing here. Give maximum little extra power here. Uh-oh, whoosh. And sometimes they will go haywire and do a little extra damage, so you gotta be really careful there. And Maxim's ready for a coup de grace. Let's see if we can bolster it a bit here. Blue's just gotta stay on healing. And luckily, I gave everyone a bunch of medicinal herbs. Actually, just gonna do a regular attack here. Now he's trying to use buff to bump up his defense. More of that crackling lightning. And now I'm ready for a coup de grace, as is Blue. Alright, so let's go ahead and unleash our coup de grace right here. Terra, you may want to heal here. Okay. Maxim's healed up a bit. Now, Blue's going to use Choir of Angels to heal everybody. Oh, whoosh coming here. Man. And Blue gets another coup de grace, as does Terra. Wow. Alright, mine. Rough and tumble. I can counter a little bit easier. Critical claim. Beautiful hit by Maxim there. 117. And we still got two guys that can coup de grace right here. How about another Choir of Angels? How about a Roaring Tirade? And luckily, Blue's not being targeted by that drain magic. Otherwise, this would be a lot more difficult here. And we stunned him, and Terra's gonna get boosted tension. Alright. Here comes another Choir of Angels. Let's see if we can crank up Terra here. See if I can get her to super high attention. anti-magic didn't work. Tension's at 20 now. That was a free shot there, so let's continue to egg Terra on. Get a little bit of magic back at least. And it looks like buff wore off as well, so that'll be a heck of a time to get some good attacks in. Let's see if I can get her to super high attention here. Insight's not gonna do anything. Maybe we'll try putting it to sleep. Can't get her to super high tension, so we're just gonna have to attack with 50 tension. Uh-oh. Well, we got a critical. Second one this battle here. I think we're gonna have to cease fire a little bit to heal up. I'm still gonna have Terra unleash here. See what she can do. 122. Definitely made a serious dent in his HP there. Still don't know how much he's got left though. Now he's going after me. Oh boy, Blue is very close to death. Luckily he was able to heal. So he bought himself a little bit more time. Can't imagine this battle going on much further. We're on about 5-6 minutes now. Oh boy. Oh, we're really pushing our luck here. Beautiful shot, Maxim. We got him. A lot of experience. Maxim gets to level 16. Terra gets to level 16. And we got a lava lump. Good for alchemy. It looks like the evil has been purged from Abbot Jack. And he has no idea what just happened. What's this? And we just got our first fig. All right. Well, now that we've saved Abbot Jack, we can exit out of here, and we can now change vocations. I'll show you what we can do at the moment once we get back to All Trades Abbey. I think I could just do an escape here. I'll just use a Chimera Wing, go back to All Trades. Alright, we've made it back to the Abbey. Now that Abbot Jack's back in power, everyone is ready to change vocations. We've also got a few side quests we can do here. Now, there are some level requirements here, and you must have a certain type of class to do some of them. So at the moment, I cannot do all the side quests. I may have to make some, basically, dummy party members so I can do the side quests here, like the Innkeeper has a side quest here, but you think you have to have a mage in order to do it. A mage of at least level 15. So, well, I'll demonstrate real quick what we can, what we have available. I'm not going to change vocations at the moment. I don't plan on doing so for a while. Got a cutscene here. Okay, so at this moment, we only have six vocations we can do at this point. We had a description for them on the top screen. Those are what we have at the moment. Like I mentioned in previous episodes, doing certain side quests will unlock even more. And then, much sought after Sage class, unfortunately, will not come till near the end of the main storyline. So, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get to that. But I will do what I can. I will probably get at least a mage up there. So at this point, we're just going to go ahead and upgrade our equipment here so we can resume our quest. Get rid of some of this old stuff. Got a lot of spare stuff I don't need at the moment. I may be able to acclimatize some of them, but not really at this time. I may peruse through my alchemy recipes and see what I can make, and if it's anything's any good, I may consider it. I'm just trying to get dressed to the nines here, get myself as fortified as I possibly can. Maybe I can get rid of something up here. Oh yeah, I got that Gleeman Groat I can get rid of. I think I've bought all I can here. Do a quick equipment check. And I think at this point, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. And we'll decide what we are going to do in the next episode. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.